And welcome everyone. My name is Mona Yadav, and in this video we will be solving one problem based on centrifugal pump. So the problem is a centrifugal pump having outer diameter equal to 2 times the inner diameter and running at 1000 rpm works against a total head of 40 meter. The velocity of flow through the impeller is constant and equal to 2.5 meter per second. The vanes are set back at an angle of 40 degree at outlet. If the outer diameter is 500 mm and width at outlet is 50 mm, determine vane angle at inlet, work done by impeller on water per second, and manometric efficiency. So by reading the question again, we get that a centrifugal pump having outer diameter equals to 2 times the inner diameter. So D2 is equals to 2 times D1. And running at 1000 rpm, that means speed n is equals to 1000 rpm, works against a total head of 40 meter. So we are aware that the head against which a centrifugal pump has to work is nothing but manometric head, which is denoted by HM. So it is equal to 40 meter. The velocity of flow through the impeller is constant. So velocity of flow through the impeller is constant. That means VF1 is equals to VF2. VF1 and VF2 are velocity of flow at inlet and velocity of flow at outlet, and the velocity of flow through the impeller is constant. So that's why we are saying VF1 is equals to VF2, and the value of the same is 2.5 meter per second. So VF1 is equals to VF2 equals to 2.5 meter per second. And as the value is equal to 2.5 meter per second, therefore VF1 equal to VF2 is equal to 2.5 meter per second. The vanes are set back at an angle of 40 degree at the outlet. If the outer diameter is 500 mm, so outer diameter D2 is given as 500 mm, which can be written as 0.50 meter. Similarly, we can get D1 is equals to D2 by 2, as we were having this relation as outer diameter equal to 2 times the inner diameter. So D2 is equals to twice D1. D1 is equals to D2 by 2, which will be equal to 0.25 meter. Now, width at the outlet is given as 50 mm. So width at the outlet B2 is given as 50 mm, 0.05 meter. Now, the vanes are set back at an angle of 40 degree at outlet. This means that angle phi is equals to 40 degree. So now we can have the inlet and outlet velocity triangles for the centrifugal pump. So this is the backward curved vane. This is the inlet velocity triangle. This is the outlet velocity triangle, where we can see that angle alpha, which is not shown here, is 90 degree, because in case of centrifugal pump, the water enters radially at inlet. And if the water is entering radially at inlet, then the absolute velocity V1 is making an angle of 90 degree with the direction of motion of the impeller. That means direction of motion of the vanes. That means U1. So V1 and U1 should have an angle of 90 degree. So if this angle is 90 degree, this means that VW1 will be 0 in this case. So that's why VW1 is not shown here. VW1 is 0. This V1 is equals to VF1. This relative velocity at inlet is making an angle of theta with the U1. So this theta and phi are nothing but the vane angles. Now this is the outlet velocity triangle, where we are having V2, VR2, VF2, VW2 and U2 as various velocities, beta and phi as the two angles. Now, tangential velocity of the impeller at the inlet and outlet can be calculated, because the formula we are aware for calculation for tangential velocity is pi d1 n by 60 and pi d2 n by 60. So for calculation of tangential velocity, we should be aware of d1 and d2 along with n. So u1 is calculated as pi d1 n by 60 equals to pi into 0.25 into 1000 divided by 60. And hence we get the value of U1 as 13.09 meter per second. Similarly, U2 we are getting as 26.18 meter per second. Here the value of D2 we have put as 0.5 meter. So that's why we are getting the value of U2 as 26.18 meter per second. Else both the formulas are same. Just the difference is of D1 and D2. So now we can calculate the discharge by the formula pi d2 into b2 into vf2. We are aware that the formula for discharge is in general area into velocity. So area in case of centrifugal pump is pi into diameter into width into velocity, which needs to be considered here is nothing but flow velocity. So that's why this is area and this is velocity. So discharge is area into velocity. So that's why pi into d2 into b2 into vf2. So we are aware of b2, we are aware of d2, we are aware that vf2 is given as 2.5 meter per second. So that's why vf2 value needs to be put here. So we get q is equals to 0.1963 meter cube per second. Now the first parameter which we need to calculate is vane angle at inlet, that is theta. So in order to calculate theta, we should be first be aware of the inlet velocity triangle. So in case of inlet velocity triangle, tan theta is equals to vf1 by u1. So if we see the diagram, we can see that tan theta is equals to v1, that is perpendicular segment divided by adjacent segment v1 divided by u1. We can write v1 or vf1, both are applicable because both are equal. So tan theta can be equal to v1 or vf1 divided by u1. So that's why tan theta is equals to vf1 by u1 equal to 2.5 divided by 13.09, which we get as 0.191. So theta is equals to tan inverse of 0.191, and that's why we are getting theta is equals to 10.81 degree. Now next thing which needs to be calculated is work done by the impeller on water per second. So it is given by the equation as W by G into Vw2 into u2. So W can be elaborated or expanded here as rho into G into Q. So rho G Q by G into Vw2 into U2. So that's why we are putting all the values. That means for density we are putting 1000 kg per meter cube. GG actually it gets cancelled. Still we have put the value. By putting the value of G as 9.81, by putting the value of Q as 0.1963. Again by putting the value of G as 9.81. into Vw2 into 26.18 is the value of U2. Now but from outlet velocity triangle we are aware that tan phi is equals to Vf2 by U2 minus Vw2. So this is the formula which we get by outlet velocity triangle. So tan phi is equals to 2.5 divided by 26.18 minus Vw2. So from this we get Vw2 equals to 23.2 meter per second. So when we get Vw2 is equals to 23.2 meter per second and we put this value here in equation number 1, we will get the value of work done by impeller on water per second as 119,227.9 Newton meter per second. Now third is the manometric efficiency and formula for which is G into HM by Vw2 into U2, and by putting all these values of G, manometric head, Vw2 and U2, we will get manometric efficiency as 64.6%. Thank you.